And ladies and gentlemen, that is a lot, and I have been at many of those. He's flown high-ranking military and civil events, including the Edwards Air Force Base Show, MCAS Miramar, NAS Point Magoo, Naval Air Station El Centro, Vandenberg Air Force Base, all these famous bases that he has flown. In addition, for the San Francisco 50th anniversary of the Golden Gate Bridge, an experienced aerobatic instructor with high ranks. And now, the smoke on, the takeoff roll, the gear has already been retracted. Ladies and gentlemen, with 600 horsepower at his left hand command, such as the round, nice round inside move, the roll, the aileron roll, the barrel roll. All of these maneuvers were incorporated. But later on, it was stationed at MCAS El Toro in Orange County, California. And it was then sent to Miramar Air Station in 1947. At one point, Wardog served as a carrier qualifying trainer on the USS Cabot in Florida. The main Wardog wears today is a replica of the St. Peter's Day ship aboard an early day serving at stripes on the wings indicate she was an instrument trainer. Walt Disney designed the logo, first and full, for MCAS El Toro. And in his honor, all aircraft based at El Toro carry WD, or for Walt Disney, on their tails. Well, War Dog also has taken on the same symbol. John so lovingly repainted that airplane and keeps it painted in the colors of when she served. It's got a 600 horsepower Pratt with the engine. Weighs 5,800 pounds. No lightweight. It's got a length of 29 feet and 6 inches and a maximum speed of around 250 miles an hour. Now there you saw the famous inside loop coming out of the same altitude. Including all the maneuvers known by military pilots who were trained. Running to the men.
Thank you.
similar thing for the done inside the pocket is to reduce the power. Just a little bit, got it back. Sets the prop at around 2,000 RPM. And the gear is still extended. There, John, with what we call down and dirty. Dirtying up the airframe by extending the landing gear out of the Well, I'll tell you what, I hope you've enjoyed this just as much as I have. It's always great to see one of these great SNJs being put through its paces by a gentleman that certainly knows the limitations of this airplane and how to get the very, very most out of it. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. John Culver in War Dog.
Who were formed in 1944 here at Camp Kearney. They flew the PB-43. Welcome to all you veterans. Boy, what a nice day to have you all.